Husky Game Prep is brought to you by Gate City Bank, proud supporter of your Huskies. Stop by and ask us about our low interest rates to finally buy that new snowmobile or ice house you've been waiting for. Contact any of our 43 locations across North Dakota and Central Minnesota, and of course around the St. Cloud area. Gate City Bank, for a better way of life. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hey Huskies fans, welcome into another episode of Huskies Game Prep, brought to you by Gate City Bank. Sam Getzinger here with you, and as always, we welcome Mick Hatton from therinklive.com. Mick, how you doing?
Doing well. How are you, Sam?
You know, I'm doing pretty well. Huskies came away with two wins on their northern trip up to Duluth against one of the top teams in the country in the Bulldogs. It was a 4-3 win on Saturday, and then on Sunday, it was a rather exciting win in overtime. 1-0 was the final score there. Nick Purbix was able to net the lone goal of the game a couple minutes into overtime. And Mick, I wanted to get your thoughts on that series. It's the second one of the row between both of these teams. What did you think from both sides?
I thought St. Cloud State found, two very different ways to win hockey games, which if you're putting them into the conference race, and here they sit in first place, you have to start considering them to be contenders here for the conference title. That's a great sign for any team. Teams that typically win conference titles, they don't win just one way. They find multiple ways to win. In the first game, they got out to a nice lead. Unfortunately for St. Cloud State, they did not play very well for a good stretch of the second period on Friday. I'm sorry, the days start to meld together here a little bit, but they give up three, and then they got a really hard-nosed goal to tie it up. I think Nolan Walker ends up getting credited with it. Micah Miller made a nice play. They got a turnover kind of right at their own blue line. Miller kind of streaked up the side. Took a shot, and then they just hammered away, at the rebound until they were able to get that one. And, Kevin Fitzgerald with a nice tip-in goal. They got two goals on tip-ins in that game. Another good sign. They want to be getting more traffic out in front of nets, and they got two of them in that game. So I thought that was a good sign. On Saturday, they came out. I was a little bit concerned, for St. Cloud State standpoint as to, well, how do you handle a really ticked off UMD team playing at home? Because they had beaten them back-to-back games, going into Saturday's game. But St. Cloud State was able to kind of, match their intensity. They ended up with 17, 18 shots or something like that. So, I mean, they weren't creating, a ton of opportunities, but the shots that they gave up to UMD, I thought mostly were perimeter type things. And David Rinnick obviously was huge in that game. So that was a great sign for St. Cloud State as well. He seems to be settling in here in the last few weeks for St. Cloud State and net. And you need great goaltending to, be a great team.
And you touched on a little bit right there after the two wins. Huskies are 9-4. And a big reason why is David Rennick, 27 saves on night one and the shutout on night two. If he continues this pace, could he be up for NCHC Goaltender of the Year?
Well, if you start only giving up three goals in a weekend, that's going to put you in contention for that sort of role. And the big thing with David, as we've seen in his career, is, can he put a string together? Now, last season about this time was when he really started to kind of lock in. And so, the hope for them and for David is that he's getting back into that mode again. Having talked to him on Saturday night, he said, yeah, for whatever reason, I get off to slow starts to seasons. But here we are, we're getting into, we're starting to get into crunch time here when you start talking about the middle of January. And he's got all the ability, to be that kind of goaltender. He's a big body. His footwork is really good. His positioning is typically very good. He tracks pucks well. He's got all the tools in the box. It's just a matter of, can he, have that on a night-to-night basis for St. Cloud State?
And as we get towards this middle part of January, finally the Huskies can see somebody other than UMD for the first time away from the pod. Western Michigan coming up this weekend. I want to hear your thoughts on this series.
Yeah, Western Michigan's a team actually, you know, they've already seen twice. You know, two kind of interesting games with Western Michigan. You know, they ended up, you know, winning the first game and ended up losing the second game, both one-goal games. Western Michigan's had kind of an interesting season in that they've been a little bit up and down. They have a really young roster. You know, and there have been times where they've had, you know, 10 freshmen in net, you know, in their lineup. So, you know, I think the big thing with St. Cloud State, they're really good on their home rink. I mean, but for whatever reason, St. Cloud State has typically played pretty well, except for last season. They typically play very well at Lawson Arena for whatever reason. I think it's going to be big to play with the lead on Western Michigan this weekend, you know, and to dictate tempo. You know, St. Cloud State wants to be pushing the pace with them, not get, you know, kind of caught on the boards and playing in the, you know, dirty areas of the ice all night long with Western Michigan. That's what they want to do. And they have a pretty good – Western Michigan's got a pretty good power play. They don't have a great penalty kill up to this point, so St. Cloud State needs to take advantage when they get on the power play in this weekend.
It should be a very, very fun season, very fun series as they go up to Kalamazoo to take on Western Michigan, the Broncos. Mick, always a pleasure to have you. A nice show on Huskies game prep this week. We'll be back again next week.
Hey, thanks so much for having me, Sam.
Have a good one.